sports tennis sensation Alex Ayala makes history as she becomes the first Filipino. Meanwhile, in sports, tennis sensation Alex Ayala makes history as she becomes the first Filipino to win a Grand Slam singles championship at the U.S. Open Juniors. The 10th seed stunned Czech number 2 seed Luci Havlíková 6-2-6-4 in the finals. Ayala utilized a reliable forehand, which was on fire throughout the match. She earned 2 break points in the 9th game with a down-the-line winner. A netted backhand service return gave Ayala 2 championship points, and another Havlíková netted backhand error resulted in victory for the Filipino.
Hindi lang para sa sarili ko, kundi para makatulong din ako sa kinabukasan. Mabubulok na itong pinaglaban. Hindi lang para sa sarili ko, kundi para makatulong din ako sa kinabukasan ng Philippines. So hindi lang ito panalo ko, panalo natin pa.
Sobrang emotional ka after the win. What does this mean to you, this trophy?
This, I think, is just... it's just everything I've worked for, and of course I'm going to work even more. This isn't the end, this isn't my end goal, but it's definitely a huge landmark in my journey.
Ayala is now the only Filipino with 2 junior doubles Grand Slam titles. She is currently the world number 297, and with 2 ITF titles under her name, her family couldn't be any prouder.
Thank you for following Alex ever since she was like 6 years old, 7 years old, going all around the Philippines, Baguio, Visayas, Mindanao, all over. And then now that, I can't believe it, she's now actually US Open champion. Sarap. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
So proud of her. She deserves everything that she did.
She was very focused, calm, at four hole. Voilà, the tactic was to change a bit the position, to put more pressure. And she didn't miss one ball, and she was very, very focused. So proud of her.
Yeah, how happy are you?
More than 10, huh?
President Marcos congratulates Alex Ayala for her historic U.S. Open victory on Twitter. Marcos thanked Ayala for raising the Philippine flag in the field of tennis and for making the country proud. Lawmakers also lauded the teenage tennis sensation. Among them, Senator Alan Peter Cayetano, who called her an inspiration to Filipinos. House Speaker Martin Romualdez, meanwhile, cited her hard work and dedication, which enabled the Filipina to shine at the global stage. Philippine Sports Commission Chairman Noni Ayala, who is Alex's uncle, meanwhile, described the win as a testament to the Filipino spirit and the strength of character.
Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing today with our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotto.
Good morning, Mike and Nikki. Here are the latest stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community.
As her 12th Canadian Prime Minister, I'm having trouble believing that my last sit-down with her was my last. I will so miss those chats.
We begin with Prime Minister Justin Trudeau leading Canada and mourning the death of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, who was also Canada's head of state. As the Canadian flag was flown at half-mast in government buildings, Trudeau paid a touching tribute to the Queen.
She was one of my favorite people in the world, and I will miss her so.
News of Queen Elizabeth's passing also saddened Filipino Canadians.
I feel so sad because she's a great loss of the world. She's a great mother, a role model, and of course she's the Queen of Canada. So I feel so saddened of her death, and I pray for her.
Canada will observe a 10-day period of mourning followed by a national commemorative ceremony to mark the Queen's death. The half-masting of flags will end when the sun sets on the day of the Queen's funeral. And we head to San Francisco, where we meet Phil-Am teen Dominique Cabading, who just competed for a spot on the 18-and-under women's national basketball team in the Philippines.
The coaches were amazing, and I really loved how they played. They were very super fast. I think I'm fast, but they're super fast. They have great ball handling skills. They play really hard, so I really enjoyed that. When I was there, it was just an amazing experience.
Dominique performed well, but due to the ongoing process of her dual citizenship, she'll have to wait a little longer to join the team next year. Meanwhile, for Dominique's father, Leo Cabading, the opportunity for her to represent the Philippines is special for the entire family.
It was an honor. None of us have ever done anything like that in my immediate family, and so just the fact that she was considered is, you know, was an honor. You know, so it was a shocking, of course, you know, but we're really proud of her.
And those are the top stories amongst the Filipino community in North America. You can catch more of our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.